right is right. Radical Islam is wrong. Jihad Islam is wrong. And we have to confront them. And we are not going to be a bystander like the United Do-Nothing Nations. We are here as the voice and my fellow human being. Let be the change. Let be the change that we want to see in the world. Because we always assume that this world of ours, it is a world need to be a world of peace, world of love, world of reconciliations, and world of togetherness. But this world is polluted. This world is violent. There are those who call me that I'm an infidel. I'm not an infidel. I'm a human being like any other human being. Don't turn a blind eye when Israel is being attacked because they happen to be a Jewish. They are part of the human society of ours. Don't be a bystander when we are being attacked in Sudan. And at the time when we talk about let's get along, how can we get along as long as Ahmadinejad want to wipe our Israel off the map? How can we get along as long as Hezbollah is waging an evil war? How can we get along as long as Hamas is there building his power to kill innocent people? My fellow human being, the power is in your hands. Let's be out and fear not. Fear not. Fear not. Let's confront the evil, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much. The next speaker who's coming to stand is Mohammed Yahya.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming in this rainy time. Thank you for coming to share with us this critical moment in our life. My name is Mohammed Yahya. I am from Darfur. I am a Muslim. I am from the same country where my brother Simon Deng came from. He is from South and Christian, and I am a Muslim from Darfur. But we are all victims of the same evil. We are all victims of the same fundamental radical regime, which is called the NCP, National Islamic Front. National Islamic Front and National Congress Party, which is working day through the night with cooperation with those radical Muslims along the world, including Osama bin Laden. As just mentioned, he was being hosted in Sudan for quite a long time because he was expelled. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a big duty. We have a huge worries because the Muslims, those who are radicals, those who are bad Muslims trying to eliminate, trying to eradicate, trying to kill and wipe out Jewish, even Muslims like me, who are black Muslims, they have no place in Sudan. Exactly like the southern Sudanese people who are Christians, they have no place in Sudan. And also like Hindus, like Sikhs, like good people, and even Christians, they have no place to live in our world today. We are facing the murders wherever. We are facing killings and rape and destruction and bombing, suicide bombings everywhere. And they taught us in our schools that you are a good Muslims. You are better than Jewish. You are better than Christian. You are better than animist. You are better than infidels. And you have to hate them. You have to kill them wherever you get them. You have to fight against them. Unfortunately, when we came here in the United States of America, who are a good people? Jewish are a good people. Who are a good people? Christians are a good people. Who are a good people? Even those who don't have any religion, who are so compassionate, who are so friend, who are so great, who are so generous, they open their hearts to us when we have been driven out of our country. We have no freedom in our own countries. We're ruled by Muslims, those who are radical Muslims. You have no freedom of expression. You have no freedom of any talks. You have no freedom to say anything right or in your behalf of your people. Ladies and gentlemen, our people in Darfur killed and they driven out to go to Israel. When they go to Israel, Israel welcomed them. They given them schools. They given them medicines. They given them shelters. They given them food. And even they given them IDs. Who is the real enemies, ladies and gentlemen? Israel, Jewish, or Christians, or radical Muslims? Who are the real, evils? Who are the real enemies? The enemies who are killing innocent people, regardless of anything, just because they are not expressing or practicing the same ideology that they did. They have been killed just because they have that the right to adopt any religion that they want. They don't have any chance to live with them. And that's why we see them everywhere, because we failed to stop the killings in Holocaust. We failed to stop the killings everywhere. And that's why it spread over, and they will come here in the United States again. They will come here again, ladies and gentlemen, if you are not stand together. We should stand together. We should support each other. We should say no, no to the killers, no to the radical Islam, no to the evil, no to those who are trying to eliminate the human beings like you. It is an opportunity for me to thank you all and to thank this country. But I have just one last message. One last message to our administration, to our Obama administration, and to Gresham, who is the special envoy of Sudan right now, who are trying to go to Sudan to normalize the relationship with the terrorist regime. They're trying to cooperate with the terrorist regime. Say no for normalization. Say no for normalization with the evil. No normalization with the regime that killing innocent people in Darfur. We should hold them accountable. And thank you for the opportunity. Long live America. Long live Israel. Long live freedom fighters. We hope that God will bless all of you to continue to do the right thing for the right people. Thank you so much.